Welcome. I am J.M. Arifur Rahman, Associate Professor, Department of Chemistry, Dhaka Residential Model College. Today's topic is Chemical Science, Acid Base, Part 1. At first, we discussed about the modern concept of acid and base. Arrhenius theory. According to this theory, acid is an species that releases hydrogen ion in aqueous solution. Example is HCl. Base. Base is any species that releases the hydroxide ion in aqueous solution. Example is sodium hydroxide. Now, neutralization reaction. According to this concept, production of water by combination of hydrogen ion and hydroxide ion is called neutralization reaction, where hydrogen ion plus hydroxide ion is equal to water molecule. Now we discuss about Bronsted Lowry theory. Here, acid is a proton donor, base is a proton acceptor. Example for Bronsted Lowry theory. HCl plus ammonia is equal to chloride ion and ammonium ion. Here, hydrogen ion is transferred from HCl to ammonium ion. So, HCl is acid, ammonia is base. Now, conjugated acid-base pair. Some acid acts as a base after donating proton to base, that is, it can accept proton. Some bases, on the other hand, acts as an acid after accepting proton from acid, that is, it can donate proton again. They are conjugated acid base of each other. Another example. For conjugated acid-base pair. Here in the equation, we see that sulfuric acid plus water is equal to bisulfate plus hydronium ion. Here, proton is transferred from sulfuric acid to water molecule and form bisulfate and hydronium ion. Here, proton is transferred from bisulfate sulfuric acid and bisulfate, so they are conjugated acid-base pair. They are conjugated acid-base pair. On the other hand, water and hydronium ion, here proton can be transferred from one another, so water and hydronium ion are conjugated acid-base pair. So we say that chemical species whose formulas differ only by one hydrogen ion is called conjugated acid-base pair. Now, Lewis theory. According to this theory, a Lewis acid is any substance such as hydrogen ion that can accept a pair of non-bonding electrons. On the other hand, Lewis base is any substance such as the hydroxide ion that can donate a pair of non-bonding electrons. So, a Lewis acid is an electron pair acceptor. Lewis base is an electron pair donor. We see in the equation that hydrogen ion is an acid. On the other hand, OH ion is an base. Another example of Lewis acid, Lewis theory. Here, boron trifluoride is a triangular planar molecule which has an empty pz orbital. So, BF3 can act as a Lewis acid. On the other hand, ammonia is a Lewis base. So, BF3 can react with ammonia. In the equation, in the figure, we see that there is a lone pair of electron in nitrogen atom in ammonia. On the other hand, a empty pz orbital bf3. This lone pair of electron is going to that empty orbital and form this acid base complex. Amphoteric substance. According to the Bronsted Lowry theory, the species which can act as both acid and base is called amphoteric substance. Example, water, hydrogen carbonate ion, hydrogen sulfate ion, dihydrogen phosphate ion are amphoteric substance. Another example of amphoteric substance. Amphoteric substances can act as either an acid or base because they have both transferable hydrogen and an atom with lone pair of electrons. Here we see that water acts as a base. Here water acts as an acid. Here water can accept hydrogen ion from HCl and form hydronium ion. So here water as a base. Water is a base. The last equation we see that water can donate an proton to ammonia. So here water is an base. More example of amphoteric substance. Here three pairs of equation where bicarbonate, bisulfate and biphosphate are shown. In the first equation, bicarbonate is a base. The second equation, bicarbonate is an acid. The third equation, bisulfate is a base. The fourth equation, bisulfate is an acid. The fifth equation, biphosphate is a base. The last equation, biphosphate is an acid. Now, strength of acid. Acid strength refers to the tendency of an acid to dissociate into proton. The stronger acid can dissociate completely into hydrogen ion in aqueous solution, but weak acid partially dissociate. The strength of oxyacid depends on the oxidation number and atomic size of central atom of acid. The higher the oxidation state, stronger the acid. So, acids can be written according to their strength. Here, perchloric acid is the strongest acid. Nitrous acid is the weakest acid. Here, the oxidation number of central atom is seen in the equation. When the oxidation number are equal, then atomic size control the acidity. For example, nitric acid and phosphoric acid. The atomic size of nitric acid, atomic size of nitrogen is smaller than that of phosphorus. So, nitric acid is stronger acid than phosphoric acid. Again, we write the acid according to their strength is perchloric acid is strongest acid and after that nitrous acid is weaker acid. Now we see the hydroxide of group 17 elements, that is hydrogen fluoride, hydrogen chloride, hydrogen bromide and hydrogen iodide. Here the acidic properties increase from HF to HI. This is explained by the fact that the bond energies decrease from HF to SI. Other factor is electronegativity and atomic size. The strength of hydroxide depends on the electronegativity and atomic size of central atom. If the electronegativity decreases and atomic size increases, then the acidity increases. It is shown in the figure. We see that hydrogen iodide is strongest acid, hydrogen fluoride is weakest acid. Because electronegativity of iodide is less than electronegativity of fluoride. Now there are some general questions. Question 1, explain a Arrhenius concept and Bronsted Lowry concept of acid and base with example. Second question, explain conjugated acid base pairs with examples. Third question, explain amphoteric substances with example. Question 4, show that water is an amphoteric substance. Question 5, write down the conjugated acid base of the following substance: sulfuric acid, phosphoric acid, sulfurous acid, carbonic acid, hydroxide ion. Compare the strength of the following acid with explanation: hydrogen iodide and hydrogen chloride, phosphoric acid and sulfurous acid. That is the end of the lecture. Thanks to all.